Shaukatali.
I'm Bandula Jayasekara, standing in for young Faraz Shaukatali, who's going to play golf this morning. Good morning, Maithri Bandula.
Morning.
Now, I mean, let's get to the point straight away. Now, the world leaders have taken center stage. You know, you just watched the meeting with Trump and Kim. And everybody, I mean, seems to be doing well. We have more statesmen. Whatever people talk of Donald Trump, I think he's trying to make America great again. But what's happening to Sri Lanka? We have a major illness. They all want to live in vehicles. Luxury vehicles, nothing else. They don't care about the masses. But what's happening? We should be ashamed, Maithri.
Bandula, always, every time, our leaders have given very bad examples, especially for the world and even in Sri Lanka. And today, you can see the dollar is going up by the day.
It's nearly 160.
It's 160. That doesn't say very much for the economy. And still, we are going into high expenditure, and there is no steps with regard to austerity being taken to reduce the burden on the masses. Now, for instance, see, Dr. Mahathir Mohamad, as he came in, within the first 10-15 days, they immediately said the members of parliament, the ministers, are going to take a pay cut. Right? And our guys are fighting with regard to vehicles. Now, I saw a few days ago, the president was telling that how Mahinda Rajapaksa took some of his vehicles, or the prime minister took some of his vehicles. So they are like children.
They are all doing the same thing. Give me my toy back, you know. That sort of thing.
They're like children, they are playing with vehicles. And you take the garment. There are so many vehicles which can be used, right? And for a long time. But everyone who gets into office, you know, Bandula, the first thing they do is they go in for the most expensive vehicle to be used.
Using our money, people's money.
It's not their money. If it is their money, there is no problem. If it is the individual's money, there is no problem. But the moment someone goes into office, he or she feels that using the successor's vehicle is degrading.
So he wants a new vehicle.
He wants a new vehicle. So this is an absolute...
But now you're also working for the government. You're a chairman of some corporation. Right?
I was, but I used my own vehicle.
You didn't use a government
No, I didn't use a government vehicle. They paid for the petrol. I mean, I got the allowance I had to get for using the vehicle. But I didn't use any of their vehicles. I always used my own vehicle.
But when are they going to deliver? Because we have
they
become a talk
deliver.
Shop.
No, they
become
never,
a talk shop.
No, but don't ever expect delivery. Delivery is not going to happen. Only consumption. They will consume, and they will take this country down the garden path to the cleaners.
That means both the SLFP and the UNP. I will say the opposition, joint opposition, all together. Because they are one club, Maithri.
No, joint opposition also, during their tenure, they also did the fair share of wastage.
Yeah, but now that's why they were defeated.
They were defeated, but now these captains, they were vehemently opposed to that. They came saying that they're going to stop it, but they're doing it worse than their predecessors. And the sad thing is they're not delivering. At least the predecessors delivered some on some. But these people are not delivering, they're only just talking. And nothing is happening. It's a very sad situation.
Well, what do you propose? I mean, people are getting fed up. People are getting tired.
I of course feel, I mean, I'm coming back to the change of the electoral system. How much people, some are criticizing it. But I feel that the electoral system has to be changed. They have to go back to the first past the post system. Now, if you take the bond scam and the MPs' names coming out, right? All this is why they are saying it was to fund the election campaign. It was to fund the election campaign. So you can see, right, some MPs, it's 3 million, 1 million, 5 million, some are 1 lakh, right? So large sums of money are being spent for election campaigns.
But I'm saying both, whether it's be it SLFP or UNP. Now we still don't know the real names, but still now we have had that's a jazz secretary. We have had Sujiva Senasinghe.
There are several other names coming in. lawyers or doctors, Bandula, this PR system will not allow a person like you to ever come and contest.
We are not even interested.
It's not the case of not being interested. But now you are a person who are a public figure. People know you, right? And you have been in the diplomatic service before this. So people like you have contributed. You all have, wherever you all have been, you all have done certain things. You all have every right to come back. And if you want to serve your hometown, to come and serve your hometown. But under the PR system, you won't stand a chance of a snowball in hell.
But now you are a presidential advisor, aren't you?
No, not anymore.
I mean, you're close to the president. No, sure, you can tell him. You can make a change.
I don't think...
I'm sure he'll listen to you, Maithri.
I don't think he listens to anyone. That's the problem. He hardly listens to anyone. He decides what he has to do. He
does not even to Shiral.
I don't think... I mean, poor Shiral. People think that, you know, he's the main advisor. But if Shiral was advising and if Shiral's advice was taken seriously, I think he would have been in a better footing right now. I
mean, but there are plenty of advisors, be it the president or the prime minister, there are plenty of advisors.
The point is...
So, I mean, they should listen to some good advisors.
Unfortunately, they don't listen to advice. That is, they think they know it all. When you reach that position, they think that they know it all. And they do exactly what they want. I mean, otherwise, Bandula, would you ever see people making this type of statements? Right now, I don't want to go into it, but social media has very, very clearly, and even media channels have played what he said before and what he's saying today. So it's a complete contradiction. So before anyone makes a public statement, and especially a person like the president and the prime minister, and very, very responsible ministers in many other countries, I have seen that they always read off a note because they are so careful on the message they deliver to the public. So any serious discussion, it is read off, right? And they are told, okay, you know, these are your parameters. You can't speak more than that. But our guys seem to be going off the cuff, just slithering. And after that, what happens is, you know, they are confronted, and then what they do is they take the law to their own hands, and they cancel licenses of channels.
Or they blame the media.
Yeah, they ultimately what happens is they blame the media. Media is there to expose, so you must be able to function without being exposed, or you must do the right thing so that there is the need to be exposed is not there, right? So when they expose. The moment they expose what they do is they come and, I mean, whatever said and done, TNL has been very critical of me. But I don't in any way condone the license being cancelled and them being harassed.
But we don't know who is doing what, like that famous slogan, make out the Mukadagarane. So that's just what has happened. People don't know.
No. I mean, no. Bandula, you can't say who.
I mean, what's happening? So that's.
No, that's the thing. No, the cancellation. It's very clear. It is coming from the presidential secretariat, which is wrong by any means. By whether it is Rajapaksa's, Sirisena's, Vikramasinghe's, Bandaranaike's, curtailing of the media is wrong. If they have done or broadcast something which is palpably incorrect, then it is a different matter. There is a different course of action for that. But if they have shown what happened in 2015 and what is happening in 2018, I mean, the public is entitled to know that.
Going to the papers today, some people call you a hitman. Are you a hitman?
No, they call me
a hitman
for Kilimaraja.
Been used.
Yeah, they are calling me. I'm a hitman for Kilimaraja. Now the JVP is trying to indicate that they are a hitman for President Sirisena. So they are entitled to say what they want. But I have always come forward and fought for the truth. Even in the bond scam, I have come at my at personal risk. And I think the Sirisa media, they were the pioneers in bringing exposing this. So I have been right throughout associated with y'all, but I don't think I'm a hitman. I mean, whatever I want, it doesn't happen with this television network. Right? There are certain places we disagree. I mean, people are entitled
and,
to...
And you have also received a letter of demand.
I am exposed at personal peril. This is not, these are not easy things. Now, the JVP is a deadly force. No, 89, 90, you remember, they used to shoot people, kill people, cut their necks, put them on fences. People have forgotten about it. Even then, in 89, 90, we took on the JVP in the south. We never ran. We have our plantations there. We never ran. When they came, they nearly shot my father. He came very, very close to death. Right? They came, they have come to our house. They have taken our weapons. Right? So, the JVP, this is good. Sending a letter of demand. At least you can pay the money and get away.
So luckily you didn't get a letter from Kirti Vijay Bahu.
Kirti Vijay Bahu.
Or the late Kirti Vijay
Bahu. Precisely. So they say I feel the JVP now has advanced from Kirti Vijay Bahu. Now it's Sunil Vatagala.
Must be your friend and colleague.
Colleague, correct.
Now, coming back now, I just got information, I don't know how far it's correct. They said there'll be more deputy ministers or state ministers. They are talking of Ranjit Aluhare, Lucky Jayawardena, Nalin Bandara, Ajit Manapperuma, Buddhika Padana. I'm saying I'm not trying to favor Buddhika Padana, he deserves.
If at all he and Vasanta Aluhare deserve it, because...
Ranjit Aluhare,
they deserve it.
But then, that's good, but... So, I mean,
it's not justified.
Bandula,
now there are ministers who are getting caught to the bond scam, right? So, what are they going to do? What are they going to do for them? Now, if a government servant gets caught stealing 10 rupees, right, he's immediately interdicted. An inquiry is held.
You're an ordinary poor person.
Immediately. Now, ministers, members of parliament, they are being exposed. There are B reports filed with cogent evidence in court, supported by senior officials like Mr. Yashanta Godagoda from the Attorney General's Department. Thankfully, they are coming and exposing these people. And I'm told, Bandula, even the police, the CID, is being called and threaten not to expose this name. So, whatever said and done, I mean, CID is not in its best condition right now.
Because
Bandula, it has for the longest time become a tool of the politician to fix the opponent. And there are enough cases I can give. I mean, there is a very, very, very famous case. Manama Tilakaratna versus Bandula Vikramasinghe, right?
Yeah, the former, who was known as Shaw Vikramasinghe. Yeah.
Right, where they completely fixed the case and got arrested him. So, CID is not, all clean and a bed of roses. But anyway, they have at least now, maybe these are some of the benefits of the Yahapalana. I mean, Yahapalana is not all bad. There are some benefits.
Yeah, that we have to acknowledge.
We have to acknowledge. So these are some benefits which are slowly kicking in, where the CID may be getting a little independent, where the AG's department is getting a little independent. I have known Mr. Kodakoda. He's an independent officer. He has come forward. He has exposed the names. And there are many, many more names to come in.
No, what's Mr. coming back? Let's continue this discussion. What happened to that Pula deliverer? He's quiet. What happened to that
Pula? That Pula is quiet. But I have my reservations with regard to the conduct of Mr. Dappula de Vilera. Personally, I don't want to bring it out right now. But
yeah.
I have
they been sidelined?
No, it's not a case of sideline, Badula. Now, I suppose a certain file is allocated to a certain officer. So once it is allocated in the AG's department, You can't remove it. You can remove it for some wrong of that officer. But once you have allocated it and once he gives an opinion on that, then matter is sealed.
But we are talking of commissions. We have another commission, Sri Lankan Airlines. But nothing is happening.
Bandula, it's good
to have commissions.
No. The point is, Bandula, now at least...
Things are coming out.
With the bond commission, now the main commission report has been handed over to the AG. On that, they are now revealing various aspects of that whole thing. And that is coming out with regard to the investigation and how the monies have been dispersed and all that. So what I'm saying is, Bandula, those are good things. I mean, it is not with the speed which you and I like it to happen. That is the sad thing.
Yeah, but it's happening.
It is happening. So therefore, I feel these officers coming and doing it independently, coming and exposing these names in court, right, is going to give confidence to the others. So this type of thing has to be encouraged and supported, and even these officials have to be appreciated, because ultimately, Bandula, I mean, when they retire, they just go home. Sometimes he may not get his promotion, but still, people like Mr. Kodakoda, they are now coming and exposing this without now. He's a very senior officer. He's a very senior officer in the department. I mean, he can miss his promotion as being AG. He's a competent guy.
He's honorable as his late father.
I mean, he was a few years senior to me at law college, but he has been a very honorable person. And when you go to meet him even on any matter, he's very decisive. He makes a decision. Right or wrong, he makes a decision. I mean, that's what you vote for, Bandula, in a country. Not where things are procrastinated on and on and on. It goes on for years, decisions. Aegis department, you know it, right? Sometimes to get a file finished and a case concluded, it takes 3-4 years or 5-6 years.
You were
at the department. I was at the department.
Now, coming back, have you stopped Ranil bashing, or you're still at loggerheads with the Prime Minister?
When did you last meet him? I met him long time ago at a wedding, and that's all the last time I met him, and he was not very pleased to meet me. No, it is not a case of bashing, Bandula. What is bad is bad.
Are you still a UNP? You have your own party.
No, I have my party. You know, I have a lot of sympathy, and I have a lot of, I mean, I have grown in the UNP for 20 years. So it's not a case where you can remove it. It's like going to a school.
Yes.
Just because you're sacked from the school, you don't, that attachment to the school is there.
You're not sacked.
Right? I was in the UNP. I was sacked.
Yeah, but not the school.
I came close to that.
Yeah. So coming back. So you feel it, but I know you. What do you think? I mean, you think he can make a difference,
Absolutely. I think he has blown it to the maximum. Now, with regard to the bond scam, right? He's doing, Bandula, these poor fellows are getting caught. Now, I know, we also have run election campaigns, right? People, you need external funding, right? So people come and give money, right? But in this instance, I mean, you know, these perpetual treasuries have been involved in a major scam.
So you need to
exercise a bit of caution. Now, for instance, when I'm doing a campaign, we'll say illicit hooch brewer, right, comes and gives me money. I'm not going to accept it, Bandula, because I know, right, once he pays you that money, he will want umpteen numbers of favors.
Yeah, but looks like, even these MPs, like it or not, they have accepted money, and they say,
those are lame excuses, Bandula. I mean, what I'm saying is, okay, if you have accepted it, for God's sake, okay, election campaign, now I think Dayasiri, he said, yes, I got the money, right, election campaign. And I was watching this, I have been watching, he has been vehement critic of the bond scam, right? So, he has been vehemently criticizing the bond scam. So, I mean, when you look at the conduct,
I mean, I'm not trying to pass any judgment, but that he has been a critic. But then, this came out of this bond commission.
Yeah.
But he should have said, okay.
I agree. I'm saying,
even now,
because the list is quite long, even now, if they have accepted it, please admit it. Now, I am asking Mr. Kabir Hashim, the chairman of the former general secretary of the UNP, tell us whether you have accepted or not. Right?
He's got enough money to give it to
perpetual. No, that is not the point.
You think he got enough money?
I don't know. I hope he has. Right? But the point is, Bandula, I am asking, this is a matter of public importance. Our treasury, central bank has been stolen. That money has been dispersed. So we are only asking, Mr. Kabir Hashim, have you or your brother-in-law taken this money or not? Answer yes or no. Doesn't the public of this country have the right to
know? But aren't you happy with Kabir's response?
No, the answer is. I mean, I'm asking you, Bandula mega gatta. You are saying, "Na mage taatta yammatai salle thiyena mata denna pulwan." I mean, Kabir being an educated man, I don't think he should answer it that way. Now, even the JVP, JVP has, they try to portray that they are paragons of virtue. Right? Now, even they have accepted money from perpetual treasuries. They threw Mahesh Senanayake. Right? So, all I'm asking them is, have you accepted or not? Now, they think that they can send me a letter of demand for 500 million and shut me up. That's not going to happen. The JVP tried to shut our mouths and shut us in 89 and 90. That also didn't happen. We openly took them on. They cannot, because this is the truth. People have to know the truth.
Maithri, where do you get your campaign funds from? Now you have a new party, you contest the recent elections. Where do you raise money?
There are family members, and it is my father funds me a lot. I have my own funding. Right, very few funding comes from outside, Kamandula. So it's a very difficult thing. I mean, running a political party is a very costly thing. But all in all, I mean, why I'm doing this is, Bandula, I feel that if all, I'm a self-proclaimed person saying that I'm a good person, self-proclaimed,
yeah.
Right? But
so you say you are a good person.
I self-proclaimed good person. So what I'm saying is, if all of us remain silent, right? I mean, there is no one to talk. Now, for instance, you take the bond scam, the JVP is silent. The joint opposition is silent. The SLFP is silent. The UNP is helping it. So it is our party, United National Freedom Front. We are the only people. And then Mr. Kirti Tenakon from the cafe. Very few. And obviously the media.
Yeah, led by the media.
For the media to even broadcast something, someone must have come and interpret it, come and talk about it. Right? So there are Mr. Usuripal Tenakon.
But have you got any information about any members of the joint opposition accepting money?
There is information, Bandula, but
you can't name names.
I don't want to name names right now. It is coming. It is coming out.
When do you think it will come out?
Give it another 2 weeks' time.
All the names will come out.
Yeah.
But then now, having said that, now especially I'm talking about the so-called Colombo Society. They talk, but when they meet these ministers and all I've seen at functions, they garland them, they receive. They don't care, you know, yes. Or they care or to question. Yes, now, yes. I have experienced this with my good friend Faraz. They ask us, the media has played an important role, but they shut them out. So why can't they also stand up?
Precisely. Now, it is Bandula, naming and shaming would be the name of the game. No, and one thing is this, like now, for instance, you take the water. I mean, basically, I feel that these people who have got caught to these camps, come on another election, they will be voted again. So what do you do? I mean, this has happened.
No, I don't think. I mean, people are tired. People are fed up.
I have in that department.
This is what our channel. We are trying to empower the masses.
No,
this
definitely,
is what we are trying to do.
You all are doing a very, very good job at that. But I don't know, Bandula, whether our voter still is up to that level.
Have we got an alternative?
The alternative is, Bandula, the point is this, it has to be a complete change of the election system. And there, like the first past the post system those days, where your electorate, right? If it is you and someone else, they will look at, Bandula Mata, you know, basically, within a short period of time, I mean, you will get a 40% change of the quality of the candidate. Right? Come 2 to 3 elections, right? The candidate, and the other thing is, Bandula, I feel, I'm strongly advocating, parliamentarians should not be given any kind of perks like permits and, you know, all this. They should not be given fancy salaries. It is a service. It's an honorable service. You refer to a member of parliament, honorable member of parliament. Honorable.
No, I mean, I remember Buddhika Vatirna said we should not call them honorable. They are not honorable.
They are not honorable.
They are not doing an honorable job.
And they are not being honorable either. Neither are they doing an honorable job, neither are they, being honorable. I mean, being honorable is to be, you come, you speak the truth, you do whatever is correct, but they don't do it.
So then what do we do?
Well, change the system, put new people, people like you must come in.
Oh, no.
People like you must come in. If the good fail to come in, then we are doomed.
Yeah?
And you take places like Singapore, now see, Bandula, Singapore is today in the world map, small country, right? 50 years ago, I mean, it was like a shanty town, right? Today they are on the world map because what? They have got top technocrats to come and run the country. So they have put the country.
Oh, our Prime Minister got Arjuna Mahendran to come and run the country from Singapore.
The worst choice he has got. The worst person he has got here. And he has tarnished the country, he has cleaned the central bank, right? So that is his choice. Prime Minister's choice is, I mean, when he chooses the worst guy. I mean,
but you were speaking of law and order, Maithri. But then, why people, the ordinary masses, they are very unhappy because you can't have one law or rule for you, another one for somebody else. Yeah. So that's the thing. Everybody should be, nobody should be above the law. So that's what's happening because the viewers are asking, okay, how come the minister in charge of central bank, what's happening? I mean, I'm sure he's referring to the Prime Minister.
No, but Bandula, strictly speaking, the Prime Minister took full responsibility of Arjuna Mahendran. And when Arjuna Mahendran is fleeing after this huge fraud, technically he should have resigned. If he has anything called honorable, he should have resigned.
Sri Lanka, people resigning?
No. I mean, whatever said then, Ravi Karunanayake, right? I don't know whether he was, I don't think.
I think Ravi was asked to.
Maybe, but anyway, he resigned, Bandula. Give the devil his due, right? He resigned. Why can't the others do it? If they have been involved,
Maharapan also resigned, no once.
Yeah, but he was.
Yeah, so same thing. I'm sure they'll bring Ravi back.
We'll see. I mean, that has still not happened. But what I'm saying is, if Mr. Ranil Wickremesinghe, if he bought Arjuna Mahendran in, he must take full responsibility. And today, the law is going behind him, and he has the audacity to come and say, he's changing his address in Singapore. So he knows that Arjuna Mahendran, on a weekly basis, is changing his address. Now, if he has no contact with him, how would he know?
It'll be like that Sinhala movie, Address Nah, No Address. Thank you very much, Maithri Gunaratne. And let me end by saying, God bless Sri Lanka.
Thank you very much, Bandula. Thank you.
News First, Newsline with Faraz Shaukat Ali.